unto us. We thank God for the opportunity He gave us to come here this morning. Just waking up from our bed is not something we take for granted. A minute later, we don't wake up this morning.
Yes.
And once again, as we gather here, we are not gathering to see one another. We are gathering because the Lord called us to gather. Mm. We are gathering because the Lord wants to hear our voice. We are gathering because He that called us is more than able to also accept the sacrifice of our lips. So we don't gather just to shake each other's hand. We gather that our burden will be given unto Him. For He just said, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and have heavy laden, for He will take our yoke upon Himself." Amen?
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the living God. As we stand up to say a word of prayer, then we shall give Brother Shan to lead us with some song service. Let's be on our feet. Most precious Lord, I commit this service into your hand, my Lord. I commit this gathering into your hand, my Lord. For there is nothing in me that I bring, except that I come to claim that which you have paid in full. There's nothing in any of us here this morning, Lord, or rather this afternoon, that we can claim to be righteous.
Thank you, Lord.
But we seek thy righteousness.
Thank you.
There is nothing in our hands we bring this afternoon, Lord, but we come to claim that which you have paid in full. For you declare at Calvary, it is finished. My Lord, my God.
Thank you.
We gather to sing songs of Zion. We gather to share your word as we heard the prophet speaking this morning, William Marion Branham preaching the message and telling us that one more time is what we need as we meditate upon that this afternoon. For that is what we meditate upon this afternoon, that we are calling your name to go and do what you have done before one more time, to prove to us that thou art the same yesterday, today, and forever, to manifest your power and your anointing upon us this afternoon, that when we leave from this place, Lord, something may have changed. Something has improved, because man needs to be improved, but you don't need to be improved. You say that faith comes from hearing your word. Therefore, let our faith keep increasing by coming to your presence, by coming to hear your word, by seeking source of Zion, by dedicating our life. Let our faith keep increasing for your name's sake. That you alone we have preeminence. For you said to this church age, I stand and knock, and anyone that opens, you will come and sup with them. My Lord, my God. We pray upon the song that my brother will sing this afternoon. We pray upon our lips that you can open our lips to worship. We pray upon our heart that you can anoint our heart with your word. For David said that your laws are written in my heart that I do not sin against you. Then therefore let our heart be contrived this afternoon. Let our heart yearn to hear from you. Let our heart burn just like the two men of the world to Ramiah that said, did not our heart burn? When you were speaking to us, speak to us this afternoon. Hear our call this afternoon. Hear our cry this afternoon. And we bless your holy name for all our brothers and sisters that are worshiping in different places. Some in New Jersey, New York, anywhere in the part of the world where the saints are gathered. We join them this afternoon to glorify your name. Even down in South Africa, Brother Chris Van Aden and family, we join them this afternoon to glorify your name. And everywhere the saints are gathered, Lord Jesus, hear their cry. For we join as one. For the church of God cannot be divided, but we are united. For the invisible bride and the bridegroom has taken place. For the bridegroom has called the bride to come up. And we are waiting to come, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. For we have had a shout. The shout is the message. We are waiting for the voice to finally call us, Lord Jesus. For the shout have been delivered to the bride. The shout is the message of the hour. The bride have had a shout to make herself ready to wash her clothes and garment in the blood of the Lamb. To hasten, because he will not be long and we'll be going home. And we are just waiting for the voice to call us, Lord Jesus, to come up and defy gravity. Waiting for the trumpet to blow. For the trumpet will call us unto united with the Lord Jesus. We call up unto celebration. For the trumpet always call the people of Israel for some special occasion. And the trumpet shall sound. And the voice of God shall call. And we shall descend, ascend up to meet him. And those that are dead in Christ will rise. And Christ is descending. And we can unite with him while we are set up. Hallelujah. And that is your promise. We're not going to talk back for it. My Lord, my God, as we pour out to you this morning, I ask you, Lord Jesus, to come, Lord. Come, Lord. We are under expectation, Lord. Brother Mohammed and family, Lord, under expectation, Lord. Everyone who has been here before, under expectation, Lord. Every visit we ever had, under expectation, Lord, that you will do something special in their life. But I guess now on the way, under expectation, Lord, with his family, my Lord. My family before you, my life before you. Lord Jesus, come, Lord Jesus, and do something new as we are under expectation. We ask with thanksgiving in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Brother Shan.
Special good afternoon to each and every one of us. Again, I bring you greetings from our Savior, Jesus Christ, who is our soon coming King. And I believe, without a shadow of a doubt, he is coming back again.
Amen.
But he is coming back again for those who are washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
Down at the cross where my Savior died. We go to sing. I have a temporary home and I'm trying to find it. I don't know where my wife. Anyhow. Praise God. Down at the cross where my Savior died. Down for a cleansing from sin I cried. Yeah, to my heart was a heart of pride, singing glory to his name. Glory to his name, precious name. Glory to his name, precious name. Yeah, to my heart.
Glory to his name, precious name.
oh God. You are God, and there is none like unto you, Lord. Lord, you are the rock of all salvation, oh God. We give you praise. Oh God, we look to you, Lord, as the good shepherd, oh Lord. Oh God, come into our lives, oh God, and make us worthy. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord, you are worthy, Lord. Lord, pour me into our hearts this morning, oh God. Pour me into our hearts this evening, God. Pour me into our hearts, oh God, so that we can reference your presence, oh God. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you glory, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
We all going to turn to on the same page, 4-5. Down at the cross where my Savior died, but when he died, now we can lean on the everlasting arms of Jesus.
Amen.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine.
Amen.
We can lean, no one we can lean on and have comfort but Jesus.
Amen.
He's our Savior.
Amen.
And he's our soon coming King.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh, glory, Jesus. We give you praise.
Living God. Hallelujah.
We give you praise.
Amen.
We give you praise, God, with a grateful heart, oh Lord.
Yes,
bow down in the sanctuary, oh God.
Amen.
Lifting up holy hands with a rack and doubting, oh God.
Amen.
Lord, come down in the shekinah of glory, Lord. And Lord, fill our hearts with your presence.
Amen.
Oh God, we just
glory.
Say to God,
glory.
Be the glory, great things. He has done.
Glory.
Oh God, you have done it in the past.
Hallelujah.
And Lord, you are still doing it, and you will do it forever.
Amen.
God, we give you praise.
Thank you, Lord. Glory.
We give you praise.
Amen.
Amen. We give you praise.
Amen. Amen.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine, living on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, living on the everlasting arms. Oh God, so that we may have no fear, Lord. do not say unto us, O God, if God be for us, who can be against us? O God, we give you praise. Oh God, we pour our spirit unto you this morning, O God. We cast thy bread upon the waters, O God, for we shall find it after many days, O God. Oh God, we cast thy burdens upon you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. Oh Father, we give you praise. Oh God, you are our comforter this morning, oh God. You are our burden bearer, oh God. You are the rock of our salvation this day, oh God, in Jesus' name. You are the friend that sticketh and closer than that brother, oh God, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah to the Lamb. Are you happy this morning, oh God?
Amen.
I am excited.
Amen.
I'm happy for Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We'll all turn to 197.
Amen.
So when we lean on Jesus,
amen,
we know a great day is coming.
Amen.
So when you lean on the everlasting arms of Jesus,
amen,
that day is coming, that day will be great.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that day will be great for the amen believers.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
There's a great day coming, a great day coming. There's a great day coming by and by. When the sins of the sinner shall be pardoned right and left, are you ready for the day to come? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the judgment day? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the judgment day? We must do our best.
Amen.
Because you know when you thank you, my brother. You know when you come to God and become half-hearted, He don't like this.
No.
God is good.
Amen.
Amen.
And He's good all the time.
Amen.
We're going to sing some songs. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart.
Amen.
I hope you know these songs that I write.
Don't sing it, bro.
But we're going to
sing it.
Anyway, hallelujah.
Amen.
I come. I don't like to stand up one place, you know, brother. I like to move. I mean, this thing is so short. No problem. No problem. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his court with praise. I will say yes, it's me that the Lord has made. I will rejoice for you and be glad. Down, down, down. Lord is coming now. When it's empty and you pray, and the Lord is, and the glory of the Lord is coming down. Lord, send the fire right now. Oh, Lord, send the fire right now. Oh, Lord, send the fire right now. From the time that we were one. Oh, Lord, send the fire right now. Oh, Lord, send the fire right now. Oh, Lord, send the fire right now. And that time is the one.
Hallelujah.
And touch the Lord as he passes by. You will find he's not too busy to hear your heart's cry. He is passing by this moment. Your needs to supply. Reach out and touch the Lord as he passes by.
Sing it again as unto Lord.
Reach out and touch the Lord as he passes.
Came and preached for us the last Sunday. However, he was supposed to travel to North Carolina. And Brother Paul has dropped him off to border them on the bus via the Port Authority. And from there, he would be going to the actual bus that he was supposed to be taking was gone. So Brother Paul had a situation where he had already been consumed tiredness, and he couldn't do it. So when he calls me,
thank you, Lord.
And I take the challenge. So the gentleman finally called him and said he was at the North train station. So I was able to go pick him up and bring him and to stay over my house. Brother Paul has made some suggestion where he probably would rent a hotel room and have the guy or the pastor stay at a hotel so he doesn't stay at the train station overnight. But my home was wide open for him. And I realized when this man came to my house that it was God himself that had allowed this man to miss the bus. And you see, everything that is done, in our eyes, it may be a terrible thing. It might be something wrong. It might be something distressful. But God have used every reason to accomplish whatever it is that he will accomplish.
Hallelujah.
So here it is, this man came to my house. And I can tell you he had changed my life. And I was able to understand a little better of who our Lord Jesus Christ really is.
Jesus.
And through the prayer that he had prayed for me, and this man bring blessings into my life.
Amen.
So you see, folks, God usually use people, his people, to bring blessings,
Amen.
To bring healing to others. Can God do it himself? Of course he has. But usually, if you go back to the apostles, you see, our Lord always used other people to help other people through his name.
Amen.
So I want to give God honor and glory for the way he has worked, the way he has shown me his presence in my life.
Amen.
And the man had proceeded to tell me that if God can give you grace, if all of these things that you went through, that you are going through,
hallelujah,
and you didn't crumble down or act upon it as a human being should, and you are standing today, it's because God gave you grace.
Amen.
And if he has given you grace, that means he has a plan for you.
Amen.
So I pray that the Lord would give me power and to stop running away from him so I can do whatever it is that he wants me to do.
Amen.
So please pray for me.
Hallelujah.
And I will pray for you.
As Amen.
Praise be to the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
God bless you, my precious.
Thank you, Lord.
Anybody else?
Yes, I will assist. Okay.
God bless you.
Amen.
I love my God. Because I challenged my God already. And this God, I never used to pray before. But since I get to know this God, he showed me how to pray.
Amen.
And your prayer with the scripture, you use the word of God to pray. Because when we go to cast out devils, we cannot use our word. We got to use the word of God because the word of God is all powerful.
Amen.
And when you use the word of God, the demon has to go.
Amen.
Demon run when nobody is running him. That's the word of God.
Amen.
And I come to this God and there's no turning back.
Amen.
There's no turning back because I nearer to the journey. Then look how much I have to go back.
Mm.
This world has nothing to offer to me. I don't know for anybody. To me, this world has nothing to offer. All it has to offer is damnation.
Amen.
And sin. And Jesus Christ took me out from the miry clay and set my feet on the rock to stay. And Jesus Christ is our rock this day.
Amen.
Amen.
And why should we turn our eyes away from Jesus? He said, look upon me.
Amen.
He said, if my name shall be lifted up from the earth, he's going to draw all men Amen. Unto me.
Amen.
And comforting words like this, I've decided to live for Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I've decided to live and go to the journey straight forward. Like I was telling my brother Paul this morning, I don't like people to lie to me. Because when you lie, you're a murderer, the Bible says. I don't like people to lie because I lie like in a little joke. But you say lying, I don't like that. And Jesus don't lie that. Because in when you lie, there's a place for you called hell. So let us try and do not lie. Live in love. And this love that Jesus Christ has given unto us, no man can give us that. He gives and no, the world can't take it away. Because he gives you that. I decided to live a life to please him and him alone.
Amen.
I came in this world alone and one day I have to depart. But my destiny is I want to make heaven my home. I want to go where my Lord has prepared for me. He said, I go to prepare a place for, he said, in my Father's house there are many mansions. And I go to prepare a place for you, Shan. And when I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also.
Amen.
I don't want to go when I die and I stand before God, and God will say, depart from me, I know you not. I don't want to hear words like that. I want to hear words like this. Oh, welcome into the joy of the Lord, for thou hast prepared for you before the foundation of this world. I want to hear comforting words like that. The Bible always teaches me and says, make your election sure. Make it sure. Nobody can make your election sure. I want to encourage every one of us who have sit in these chairs, make it right with God today. Because there is no tomorrow. Now is the accepted time. This is the day of salvation. Give your heart to God totally.
before it's too late. God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Glory, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
God bless you, saints.
God bless you.
So I just, you know, when you think something or you know something happens to you, no matter how small, you always want to say thank you.
Yes.
Because you remember the lepers.
Yes.
The only one that came back.
Right.
And we know as human beings when we do something, not that they were always looking for something, but it feels good when someone recognizes it sometimes. You
Amen.
Feel at least you reach somebody.
Amen.
So my testimony is really just to say that no matter how long it takes, you know, as human beings we're under time and it's hard for us to separate our needs from time. You know that God isn't in time, but we're still in time, so we feel things.
Mm-hmm.
But he's faithful.
Amen.
All I can say is that he's faithful.
Yes.
So I graduated with my master's in nursing about, it was 2014, and I became a family nurse practitioner. I know how I was able to work and do all of my clinical hours and pass the exam in fine colors with the Lord's grace, and I know
Amen.
My struggle was to study, because even studying, I wasn't making the personal marks that I wanted to make, which was a parameter to say if you score within here and here, when you take the actual exam. And I just wasn't, I was trying and I was reading, and I still remember the day of that exam, I said, Lord, just make up this deficit for me. I've done what humanly I can, the rest is just for you. And I won't forget that feeling of just getting the few minutes when you're there with the proctor in the end, and it said, congratulations, you've passed, and I passed very well.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, Lord, you did it for me.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
But then, I was applying for jobs, networking, and nothing just seemed to be working out the way I thought. I went to interview after interview, things that I just, you couldn't tell me I didn't have it in the palm of my hand. But I didn't have it in the palm of my hand because I didn't get it. I couldn't figure out what was going on. Then after a while, I was just laying in bed and I said, you know what, Lord? You know, hindsight is always 20/20. But if I look back on my life, there's so many things that if you would have given me what I wanted, what I thought was good for myself, it was nowhere near what you had in store for me.
Mm-hmm.
I could just think of example after example after example, and I would compare what he gave me after I waited. At times it was painful because you're just going on faith. You don't know what it's going to be.
Yes.
But in the end you say, oh, you know, it doesn't feel as bad as when you're waiting for it when you get it. So I said, Lord, can you just help me to turn my mind to help condition my heart to accept what it is you have for me, because maybe what you have for me is not what I think I need for myself.
Ooh.
And I said, I know this is hard. I don't know. You know, maybe for all I know, you want me to work in a prison. I mean, I don't know, and not a hospital. I mean, it could be anything. But I know that what you have for me, there's something in it for me. There's a blessing. I'm here to be salt of the earth, not salt to myself.
Amen.
I'm already salted. I need to be salt for someone else. There's
Amen.
Something
yes.
that you need me to do.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not doing this for myself.
Amen.
I'm doing it for you. So if I'm doing it for you, I'm the clay and you're the potter.
Yes.
And it's for you to tell me what I need to be, where I need to be, how I need to be there.
Absolutely.
Not for me to say, make me like X, Y, and Z. So if you can just help me to condition my heart, I'm willing to go where you want me to go. If it takes more time than it takes for me to renew, then so be it. But I know that, you know, my footsteps are ordained by you, and all things are going to work out together for the good for me. Because I trust and I believe you, and I have to put this into action. So about two to three weeks ago, there was a job that I originally applied for. And at that time, it was a full-time job. I just didn't think, as I, you know, discussed with my husband, it just wasn't a good change. It was not even a lateral change. You know, when you like to move up, or if you're leaving something, there has to be something better, something to make sense. You know, you're not going to make a lateral change or go backwards. It doesn't make sense. So at that time, everything seemed good, but it just didn't make sense. And I kept saying, but if only this, if only this. So then, just out of nowhere, I said, you know what? Let me just call them back and say, I'm still interested in your organization. By any chance, do you have something maybe part-time? And I said, well, they're not going to go for that. And I said, you know, just do it. You never know. To make a long story short, I am in the process of starting my training there. Some way, somehow, I knew deep inside of me that there was something out of these people that the Lord wanted. Maybe it wasn't the way I saw it. Maybe it was a different way. You know, you can't operate under fear, false evidence, fear, and real. What do you have to lose? The answer is no, not now, later. Okay, you move on. So what did I have to lose with making that phone call? Well, I would have lost more not making that call, because making that call, and I heard, hold on, let me get back to you. They were able to give me what it is that we originally prayed for, which was something to augment what we already have now based on our family's needs and what it is that we want to accomplish. But I know that at some point when you have to say, Lord, just condition my heart, you know, like Jonah, maybe I'm not supposed to go here, I'm supposed to go here. After this human being, it may not look attractive to me, but maybe that's where you want me. Mm-hmm. Just somehow point me in that right direction and just meld me down so that I'm able to accept and to be where you want me to go, because I know you have only the best plans for me.
Amen.
So everything is still a work in progress, but I do know that he is faithful. He does answer prayers. He does want the best for us.
Amen.
He will deliver. His words are true. His promises are true. If we reach out to him to condition us to somehow be in a position where we can sometimes see things differently than what we think is best for us. Maybe we need a new set of glasses, a new set of eyes to see that there is something in here for me that I wasn't just able to see before. He'll do it.
Amen.
And that's my testimony.
Amen.
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 Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Anybody else have anything to say? God is well.